My dog sat there for an hour, waiting for my ex. Where we met, he was there. This photo, it just evokes so much emotion. Well, it would if it wasn't a stock image. This subreddit is already filled with enough stuff that's questionably morbidly beautiful. We don't need made-up stories and stock photos as well. Hello, Redditors of the internet, Noble Xenon here, and welcome to r/QuitYourBS Part 4. Let's get started. We go to PewDiePie submissions for this next one. Ah yes, going to the subreddit of a person who's way more famous than you to get attention and subscribers. What could possibly go wrong? YouTube just deleted all my meme videos that were family friendly and no email, no notification. My channel and days of work got snapped in less than a second. Trying to raise some attention to what's happening, but it's hard as a small crater. You know, cause Susan's going around with the infinity gauntlet like she's Thanos or something, just snapping down all those videos. Wait. She has been deleting videos like crazy? Oh, never mind then. But it's not what happened in this case, no. He actually took down all his videos and pretended they were took down by YouTube. Do not fall for this, and do not subscribe. He's trying to get free subscribers and karma out of pity. Hello, I'm looking for something affordable and friendly. I'm responsible, always pay rent on time or earlier. Shady people have scammed me before. K do take several medications for anxiety, depression, but I do have prescriptions for sure, and I always explain to roommates in case the meds make me act a little off. Last roommate was not so open-minded. Anyway, looking for me and my husband and our kitty budget. And the reply, not so open-minded, girl, you jacked me and raided my bedroom. Don't frickin' lie to people. I'm also waiting on you to pick up your TV. Also, medications aren't supposed to be burned on foil and shot up. And now we got a Forex trader lying about that new Lambo. Humility, hard work, and prayer. And you too can get the car of your dreams. Forex dude's always lying. Must be one of those accounts that show off and try to convince people to join their schemes. We are not all equal. I worked very hard my entire life to get what I have. Most of the people I know have two. I deserve where I am in life. I will not give up what I have earned so that someone who has not can feel equal. Nor will I assume their debt. I have had to pay my debt. I insist everyone else be held to the same standard. Hey Dad, aren't you in child support debt? Oof, you got called out there. Laura gave this Chinese restaurant 2.5 out of 6 stars. What website is this that has 6 star reviews? The food was terrible. I ordered a chicken dish and got small pieces of battered dry chicken mixed in with battered prawns. Totally ruined this dish. Good job I'm not allergic to prawns. I won't be ordering from them again. And the reply, hi Laura, will you please open your eyes and read the descriptions? You ordered the special sweet and sour, which contains king prawns. You got what you ordered, so how's this our fault? The food was fresh and perfectly cooked. We are good, but mind reading the stupid is not one of our skills. Damn, this owner does not take any BS whatsoever. And now the OP gets called out for trying to sell a couch he got for free. Real leather couch, $400, in good shape other than the wear on the seats. Little lighter shade than the rest of the couch, no pets, no smoking house. Lol, nice couch, we just gave this to you for free. That's literally my house in the background. FYI to those looking, this was basically my dog's couch, definitely not from a pet-free home. It's not real leather. It's heavily used and has been repaired because the frame is broken. And you can see the evidence right there, doggo and all. For this next one, we've got a beautiful picture of a sunrise taken in Louisiana. Not gonna lie, that is beautiful. Unfortunately, it's not your picture. Dude, this isn't your picture, at least credit the original post. Thanks, people need to stop pretending it's their own. And gives a link to the original r/pics. For this next one, using a photoshopped picture of Billie Eilish as an ad for a terrible necklace. Only piece of jewelry which she has and I can actually afford, link in bio. Yeah, I can see that with a laughing emoji. I can also clearly see the Photoshop. Please, that picture is so badly edited. Billie never wore that necklace. This is so fake, lol. LMAO, that Photoshop is so bad, that's not even something she would wear. And there's the actual picture, not even close to resembling the necklace that's trying to be sold. For this next one, why even pretend with something so unique? My Mustang Engine gaming PC. OP did not build this, he stole it from someone else. Here's the proof with the link. Daily Mail tweets, is Kay Burley about to leave Sky News permanently? Anchor deletes mention of broadcaster on her social media. And she simply replies with no. I mean, the Daily Mail is known for all this kind of BS, so it's really nothing new. We go to Forbidden Snacks for this next one. Was given a Ziploc bag of these for Easter for my niece. I thought they were M&Ms. They're painted pebbles. And another Redditor replies, from that picture, these just look like regular off-band peanut M&Ms. You mean off-brand? The color is sprayed on, size is too uniform, and they got that shiny finish to them. And I don't know how to describe it, but a couple of those look sugary. I guess that's the best way I could describe it, let's just move on. For this next one, we've got one that kind of also belongs on r/ I'm very badass. One time I fought three guys outside a bar. Lost my pager doing it. Paged a pager from home. They called. I told them to meet me at the place I fought. Then I showed up alone across the street and saw five dudes behind the store and one out front. As I walked across the street in my wife beater, I yelled, "You effers can just come out now and I'll kick the crap out of all of you." They were stunned. The dude out front with my pager just handed it over and said, "He's never met someone who could take a punch as well as me. I told him he's lucky this is only a work pager." Dude, just stop. 5-on-1, you'd be dead. I don't care who you are. Besides, how are you supposed to see behind the store and in front of it at the same time? What, does your wife beater have superpowers in it? Maybe it's got eyes on the back, who knows? r/WTF is going on in Paris. Except that's not Paris. It's New Jersey. Can confirm we don't put train departing in France. We prefer to use French usually. For this next one, they must have some really unlucky friends. Sorry, not interested in AstraZeneca or Johnson & Johnson. I'll wait for Pfizer or Moderna, thanks. There is no scientific reason to be uninterested, so why are you waiting? I know of three friends who had the AstraZeneca that had severe side effects, including hospitalization for a blood clot. Not for me, thanks. Only two people in Canada have had a documented clot. Your friends are three of those two people? Something isn't adding up here. The actual news. Healthcare workers can now get vaccinated without registration. Meanwhile, NDTV. Frontline healthcare workers are no longer allowed to register for COVID vaccination, says Center. This next one's titled, "You Ain't Fooling Nobody." Found a ding-dong in my coffee lid. You can tell you did it with your finger. r/QuitYourBS. r/UntrustworthyPopTarts. Drew it in my coffee lid. It sort of looks like one that's being worshipped by other smaller ones in a Stonehenge formation. Out for a hike and I just found these? Should I climb them? That's kind of weird, why are there just random stairs out in the middle of the woods? But anyway, the reply. Oh lol, not even your pick. Here it is on a list of stairs found in the woods. This one is from Germany. Really weird thing to steal a pic for a barely a joke, but hey, Twitter is weird, so have fun, I guess. But someone else comments that these stairs are not in Germany, they're actually in the UK, so where are these stairs exactly? This next one was reposted because I forgot to blur out a name. Whoops, LMAO. Well, it happens. Sometimes you just forget random things. One star. We basically went there, we had 7 people, and the rude lady said one person didn't pay. So we called the police, and the police saw the footage, and we were right. I recommend do not go here, you will have to worst customer service, or customer service as this person put it. And the owner replies, "Hi, thank you for your review. Unfortunately for us, Goggle doesn't fact check, but neither of you seem to spell check. After review of the video, police report, and counting your cash draw, you in fact stole $40 from us. Normally, we use reviews as a learning experience, but unfortunately in this case, stealing from us wasn't enough for you. I hope you don't treat other businesses the way your group treated us the other day. This next one's titled, Your Quote Sister is a Great Quote Artist. My sister drew this and I loved it, so I decided to post it here. Then it was flared with shared content, not OC. And the reply, LMAO, it's so funny. You didn't even try to search hard for a picture that was stolen. For everyone's proof, here's the image from Google. You could have just said you liked the artwork you found, but you did put it as shared content, so whatever. Just wish more people could be more honest, but it's the internet, lol. There's always gonna be dishonest people on the internet. Just take a look at the amount of Quit Your BS posts. People constantly getting caught in 4K, 8K, 12K, Ultra HD, OLED display, but they still won't stop. And now another one-star review. I see a lot of men going to this place for a massage. I've been once, but I did not feel comfortable, and I heard disgusting noises coming from next to where I was having a massage. Defo not recommend for ladies. If you want a relaxing massage, go elsewhere. And the owner replies, this person has never been here for massage services. Just spammed from other place. If you want to know where she's from, go read all her reviews so you will get the answer. For this next one, an astrologer gets told by an astronomer. The last time Saturn stationed retrograde in the 21st degree, 20 degrees, of Capricorn was in 1666, the year of the Great Fire of London. Saturn is now in the same degree and will station retrograde there on April 29th, 2019. And tragically, we have a fire at Notre Dame. Hashtag astrology. And the astronomer replies, hi. Actual astronomer here. Three things. One, Saturn isn't in Capricorn now or on April 29th, it's in Sagittarius. Two, the last time Saturn was station retrograde in Capricorn was in 1992, not 1666. And three, astrology doesn't work. Stop trying to pollute this horrible tragedy with nonsense. One star, horrible bot, horrible developers. Don't use this bot. And Catbot replies, damn, these bots are getting real intelligent. I know it's probably the developers of the bot. I wonder why. In our support server logs, it shows we banned you for DM advertising your furry paradise server and then spamming slurs and attempting to ping the whole server asking for Robux when confronted. You know, at this point, if you can't get Robux, you might as well face the oof. This next one's titled, Congrats on the Graduation, Buddy. It was posted on r/nextfrickinlevel, but honestly, I don't see anything next level about graduating college. It's quite common, even though, yeah, it's something to be celebrated, but still. Since no one in my life seemed to care that I graduated college, I'll tell a bunch of strangers online. The Regents of the University of California on the nomination of the faculty of the College of Letters and Science have conferred upon thee the degree of Bachelor of Arts with a major in Geography and a minor in English, with all the rights and privileges thereto pertaining, given at Los Angeles this 12th day of December in the year 2003. Hold up. Well, congrats on graduating in 2003. I guess the mail is slow in LA. Oh, and by the way, it wasn't even their photo either. It's on this Mercury News article. And for this last one, someone doesn't have their facts straight. Defund the USPS. I don't need my tax dollars being used to fund such a poorly run service. Private carriers are more than enough, and it's not like USPS is significantly cheaper or anything. And the reply, USPS made $77 billion this year. We don't use your tax dollars. To the contrary, its 600,000 employees' paychecks are taxed from USPS revenue, thereby contributing to the government funding. Also, private carriers are not more than enough. UPS, FedEx, and Amazon pay us to deliver packages that either aren't profitable for them or that they can't handle. We also rely on them for logistics. Having an every-door, everyday government entity in congruence with our private partners really works out well for everyone. Anyway, I'd like to thank all of my patrons, especially Benjamins, Catalin Cormendi, Spoonie the Rogue, Seth Southwell, Henrik G.F. Mickelson, and Kathy Loves Cats. You can join in a link below, and thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like. If you have something interesting to say, don't forget to comment. And if you want to see more, don't forget to subscribe and hit the little notification bell. See you guys next time.